Which are the tests you should write first? I get this question a lot in my DMs, and sometimes I get this question asked at a conference. Now, this may sound like a rookie question or something that a beginner might ask, but I have to say, this is probably not the case with this one. Mostly because you can find yourself working on a brand new project suddenly, even after years of experience of establishing yourself in a project that has been working for years. So if you have found yourself in a situation that you need to automate a brand new project, here are a couple of tips for you. First of all, I like to take a look at what is the feature that makes the company money. It is important to point the test automation to the most important thing, and that is keeping our business afloat. This advice seems very obvious, but you'd be surprised how easy it is to overlook. It is good to ask yourself, what is the most important feature of your product? What is the path that makes your company money? What's the one thing that cannot break, otherwise we'll get into trouble? Now, the most obvious might be the payment, right? The payment flow where you check out. If you're on an e-commerce store, then that might be the checkout flow. If you're working on a SaaS service, that might also be the thing. Another way to look at it is to look at your most used feature. Maybe it's the one that your customers like the most, or is the reason that they start using your product. This is something you should probably take a look at first and try to automate that instead of everything else. You can also think beyond test automation. You can ask yourself, what can you do to make sure that everything works? This means that maybe test automation is not always the answer. You can implement monitoring for your payment gate. For example, if a payment doesn't succeed, you should get an email notification or maybe a Slack or Discord notification that will immediately tell you that there was someone who was willing to pay the money but was not able to. This can save your company lots of money and is really important when you try to lower your risks. Speaking of risks, another way to take a look at what to automate first is to take a look at what is the most risky thing. Maybe what are the things that tend to break the most? For example, you might have a legacy code or you're starting test automation efforts on something that is really old. There's a lot of jQuery and maybe some older code and it needs refactoring. And that means developer jumping in, changing a lot of things, but actually not changing a lot of new features. And this is also a good clue into who to talk with when preparing your test automation. You can talk to your developer and ask them what are the parts that they are most nervous about refactoring. Maybe you'll find something that is easy for you to automate, but it's hard for them to refactor. This is a place where you can really apply a sort of test-driven development approach where if anything breaks while the developer is refactoring, they will get a red flag immediately, which will help them make sure that the risk is at minimum. A third way to look into which tests to automate or which to start to automate is to take a look at what kind of automation will save you time. Automation is a lot of fun, but it's easy to look a track of time. Remember why we automate, why we write automatic checks. It's not only to keep our application healthy, but it's also to save us time. If automation is not saving us time, it is failing one of these purposes. Remember, users don't care about your automation. They care about working product. So it's important to make sure that your test automation is actually helping you save some time, because otherwise it's just wasted effort. I know that manual testing can be annoying, and it's one of the reasons why we do automation, to get rid of that annoyance. But it's also better to spend 30 seconds daily on some annoying thing than to lose 2 or 3 weeks of your time trying to automate a thing that could easily be done in those 30 seconds. Finally, a bonus tip, automate quick wins. this is not a rule you should apply across the board, right? You want to focus on the most important things. But quick wins can sometimes help you to get a good feeling about your progress, and they can keep you excited about a project. They can also create a better coverage, even if they're not covering the most important thing. They do cover some parts that may be forgotten. And while you don't want to start your test automation efforts with just a lot of small quick wins, but actually focus on the important thing, quick wins can really help you stay motivated working on a project. So these are just a couple of tips on what are the ways to approach test automation. But let me know in the comments which are your ways of trying to approach a new project, and how do you decide on what to automate first. Happy testing, everyone. Thank you.